In this episode of Paddle TV, we are talking about how to plan for a five-day canoe trip, how to meal plan for a five-day canoe trip, because your meals will dictate whether you have a great time on a trip or an okay time on a trip. Nothing is more important than food. Before we get into it though, please subscribe to Paddle TV if you haven't already and hit that little notification bell so that you get notified when our new videos go live. And stay tuned because we've got lots more tips and tricks coming your way. So let's jump right into it. We are at Klarney Outfitters getting ready for a five-day canoe trip. Life has never been so easy when it comes to meal planning, because one of the things Klarney Outfitters does is they provide like the full outfitting experience. They do your whole meal program and they provide all your camp gear if you want. Like literally you can travel from wherever here with pretty much just your clothes and a toothbrush, and they'll have everything else that you need, and they have really high quality stuff, so it's very turnkey. What I realized as we were getting set to head out on a five-day canoe trip is it's a great opportunity to talk about the meal plan. They've got it perfectly laid out. So when it comes to a five-day canoe trip, what you need to think about is what kind of canoe trip is it? I mean, the joy of a canoe is that you can take a lot of weight, a lot of gear, but the problem with it is if you have to portage. How much do you have to portage? Because, you know, if you're going to have to portage a lot, you're not going to want to take that much weight and food. So you have to plan accordingly. What's the temperature like also? What's the spoilage issue? In other words, how long is fresh food going to last? Right now we're in fall, it's cooler temperatures, things are going to last a lot longer, so we can be a bit more liberal with our fresh foods. But still, you don't want to be on a trail and have fresh food go bad. You just want to take that chance, because then you're not eating enough calories, and you're miserable all of a sudden. So you're better off being conservative. As a general rule, what they've done here, and it's the same rule I apply, is first 2 days is great for fresh food. After that, you're pushing it. And so after that, you're dealing with dried, dehydrated foods for the most part. So the type of trip or how many portages you have really dictates the weight of the food you can consider taking. The weather helps dictate, you know, how much fresh food you take, a little bit. The next factor to consider is how many calories are you gonna burn on a trip? Is this an aggressive trip, or are you gonna be spending a lot of time hanging out in camp and you just really don't need that many calories? In our case, we're going on a pretty aggressive canoe trip. We're gonna be doing a lot of portaging, a lot of paddling. There's supposed to be some good wind and it's supposed to be cold. We're gonna be burning some calories. So we're planning around about 4,000 calories a day for all 5 days. So with all that said, you know, let's take a look day by day at the menu plan that we have lined out, starting with day one. Now it's the morning, and we're literally just getting packed up and heading out. And so for today, we have these pack lunches, some fresh sandwiches, and it's a nice, easy lunch to carry. Tonight, dinner. What we have here is we got stuff for barbecue. We got mushrooms. We have some baked potatoes that are just being wrapped right now. And we have 4 steaks. Now these steaks are frozen and then wrapped in newspaper. We're gonna take these out towards, you know, mid-afternoon to start them thawing so that they're not frozen going on the barbecue on the fire tonight. So day two, we have breakfast. Now breakfast, we've got bacon, eggs, and fresh bread. Now the eggs here, they're in this, I don't know if you've ever seen one of these egg protectors, but these plastic egg protectors are great for camping trips. What they've done to the eggs is they've actually blanched them really quick in hot water to kill all the bacteria from the shell, and that lets the eggs last longer. Although we're gonna be eating those on day two, so I'm not too worried about that. The bacon, and as with a lot of the fresh food you'll see here, what they've done is they've wrapped the bacon with cheesecloth that's soaked in vinegar. And this is a way to really extend the life of your fresh food. I've never actually done this before, so this is really cool to see. You know, it's wrapped in vinegar, so there's going to be definitely a smell, probably a bit of a taste, although Ted says that once you cook it, it's gone. The vinegar taste is gone, but that's a great idea, and looking forward to seeing that in action this trip. Lunch, we expect to do a lot of portaging on day two, so we're taking a quick trail lunch, something we can just break out on the side of the one of the portage trails, or at the top or bottom of them. Trail mix, cheese and crackers, granola bars, beef jerky. It's just some nice high calorie foods. And then there's actually peanut butter and jam. And for dinner, this is chili. And this is a beef chili, frozen, wrapped in newspaper, actually in Ziplocs, and then wrapped in newspaper to keep it frozen. We'll have to take those out, in the afternoon of day two to make sure they're thawed for dinner as well. Bringing us to day three. Day three, we have breakfast. Now this is the day we're getting into dry, dehydrated foods. We have your typical instant oatmeal for breakfast with some dried fruit on top, some good high calorie, slow burning, slow burning fuel for our internal fires. For lunch, we've got wraps, salami, and cheese. Both have been wrapped in the vinegar-soaked cheesecloth to make these wraps. Celery and carrots, something crunchy at lunchtime. And dinner, we're going to dehydrated meals. And we are expecting to burn a lot of calories, so we're going, these dehydrated meals, like most dehydrated meals, are good for two people. But if you're really working hard, you have a healthy appetite, then we're planning on one of these per person. Moving on to day four, we have the same instant oatmeal with some raisins, dried fruit for breakfast. Lunch, very similar. Again, wraps with cheese and salami, both wrapped in the cheese, vinegar-soaked cheesecloth. And on pita this time instead of a tortilla wrap, and another four dehydrated meals, one each for our group. I haven't actually tried these yet. The Happy Yak. Happy Yak Express. I will let you know how those are. Now day five, the final day. Once again, we have the instant oatmeal and dried blueberries, dried banana chips for breakfast. Salami, cheese on pita bread for lunch with celery and carrots for the crunch. And more dehydrated meals, one each for dinner time. So day three, four, and five are very similar. We also have this smorgasbord of snacks from throughout the day and in the evening. We got trail mix cookies, some a bit of fruit for early in the trip before it gets all beaten up. We'll make sure we eat that early. Pepperettes and some brownies. That's nice. Some popcorn, tea, cookies. Coffee. Coffee. I don't know if there's enough coffee there. I think we have a coffee problem. So, that's pretty much it. That's a quick summary. We're going to be cooking, for the most part, a combination on a MSR Dragonfly stove. We're bringing enough fuel, bigger fuel canisters this size. It's going to do the trick. It's going to have to do the trick, but we're planning to do a bunch of cooking on open fires too. It's going to be cold nights, and so we're going to want fires anyway. And these the campsites in Killarney Provincial Park all have some type of cooking grill platform in the campsite, so we don't need to lug anything like that around. We'll be able to do a lot of our cooking you know, boiling water, what have you, in what they call a billy can, at campsite. So we'll be doing a mix of stove and campfire cooking. Lots of food here. We got a big portage to start the day, so that'll be fun. But that's about it. Hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, make sure you leave or give it a big thumbs up. Leave a comment down below if you like this style of video. And stay tuned, because we've got lots more tips, tricks, and paddling adventures coming your way.